My name is Sarah Moulton, and I have been at Sailorville for 13 years. When I think about my life journey in the Lord, one verse comes to mind, and it's Proverbs 16:9. The heart of man plans his way, but the Lord directs his steps. I've had a lot of plans in my life, and most of them have been good, but God has definitely changed my course many, many times. Started a long time ago, 27 years ago in fact, when as a very young little girl, 3 years old, I placed my trust in Jesus Christ. Crazy right now to think of being three, now that I have children that are that age, that is the age that I came to know the Lord. But I still vividly remember the time in my mind. I still remember the poster on the wall in my house of heaven and hell and the bridge that crossed over hell into heaven. I remember being a little girl and knowing I was a sinner and that I needed Jesus Christ to be my Savior and forgive me of all my little sins. Had a pretty normal growing up childhood. When I was in eighth grade at camp, I dedicated my whole life to the Lord, and as an eighth grader, I said, Lord, I want to be in full-time ministry someday. So that's what I was going to do, and I was ready to make some plans. The next summer, the summer right before my ninth grade year, July 15th, 1995. Shit. I still remember Dad coming into my room at 4 o'clock in the morning and looking at me and asking me if I was awake several times and telling me that my mom had passed away to go be with Jesus. So that was a definite course change, not something that a 14-year-old thought was going to be happening. Getting ready to go to high school, the oldest of seven kids, with my youngest little brother not even taking his first step yet. So the next couple years, needless to say, were years of humongous growth in my life. Then, very soon afterwards, entered Marilyn Swanson into our family, soon to become Marilyn Nemers, as most of you guys know. Marilyn brought with her three kids, one of whom was a girl a year younger than me, and at 15, 16 years old, I don't need to explain much more than that. It was rough. It was very rough. I had always done the laundry for 2 years almost, you know, from my family, and it was so awkward at first for Marilyn and I to figure out that she could actually be in control of the laundry. So for a few weeks, I was actually doing my family's laundry, and she was doing like Dad and her kids' laundry. And then she probably doesn't even remember that. And then we finally were like, this is crazy. But it was awkward, like no one wanted to talk about it. It was just like, it was weird. Just as things were starting to get a little bit better and a little more normal, still remember this day vivid too, I was in the kitchen with Dad, he looks at me and he says, I need you to pray about something, honey. Sailorville Baptist Church in Des Moines, Iowa has been calling me, and I really feel that God's going to call us there to ministry. Haven't said yes yet, but I wanted to tell you, and I want you to pray. I remember looking at him, and I don't think I said anything. I just walked out the door, and we lived in the country back then. Half mile down the road was this creek, and I went under the passageway and sat down by the creek and just cried for a couple hours, thinking, God, we're finally getting it together as a family. We're finally coming as one, and you're gonna move us to this big city. So he moved us, as you know, and it was, surprise, surprise, the best thing God could ever have done for our family. A year later, I graduated from high school, started at Faith Baptist Bible College, and went there for 4 years, and I was heading there to serve God and hopefully find a husband who was in full-time ministry. I dated three different guys who are all currently serving the Lord in full-time ministry today, and God didn't have me with any of them. In fact, he had Heath Moulton enter my life, who was not in ministry at all, and for over a year I tried to push him away and refused to go out with him, finally saying, I can't ever date you, Heath, or marry you, so stop liking me. You're not going into ministry. But he continued to woo me, and a few months later, I remember going to Dad and saying, what am I supposed to do about this? I like this guy, I'm falling for him, but he's not going into ministry. And Dad challenged me and asked me to go search the scriptures for where God calls a married woman into ministry, or a woman in general, and it's not there. So fast forward, 11 months later, Heath and I were married, and I love that course change in my life. So thankful for a husband who has been able to support me financially, so that I've been able to stay home and really give a lot of my time that maybe I wouldn't have been able to if I was working outside the home. Give it to a lot of ministries here at church and women's ministries. Has just been a fire inside of my heart. Right now, my ministry is mainly to my three children and my husband, so that's been another season change for me. Each course change that I've gone through, each season of my life, has been a fight, probably. But each time, I think it gets a little better. Maybe. Right now, I really this year had to develop what season I'm in. I love being involved in like every ministry possible. But I have three very young children, and I was failing as a wife and a mom because I was doing too much ministry. So that was a big course change for me, even in this past year, realizing right now my place is more in the home. I think it all comes down to having your heart where it needs to be and your priorities where they need to be. So even if it's a completely different course than you had planned for your life, but if your heart is desiring to seek after God and you're getting with Him daily and you're spending time in prayer and in the Word, then your heart will want what He wants. And you can understand that even though this isn't where you thought it was going to go, this is obviously where He wants you.